This probably isn't really news, but there's a mystery in politics this week. What is going on with Mitch McConnell? This video from C-SPAN 2 was going around. We're gonna show you this picture. A lot of people noticed that his hand seems to have something going on. And later on, when he had to stoop to pick up his mask, you could see a little bit more and people zoomed in. And like, he's got a bandage and his hand is obviously very discolored. Now, just the 12th of October, if we go to this next image, you're gonna see his hand looking like any normal, you know, slightly older turtle paw. Like, it'll just looks like it's supposed to, but now it looks very different. And it's probably just something medical, Brett, I assume. But he's been very evasive with reporters. They've asked if he's okay, if there's anything wrong. And he just says there's nothing. There's nothing. He doesn't say why it happened, why he's wearing bandages. What do you think?
There's a lot of ways to interpret this. My preferred interpretation is that somewhere in a castle is a rose, and every few years a petal falls off the rose. And when it finally falls off, he just disappears into goo. And there's only one petal left, John. Mm-hmm. Unless he learns how to love someone and be loved in return, mm-hmm, he will just evaporate. And he has failed that. And it's showing physically that, like, there's just a little bit of one petal left on the rose, John. And he should have been nicer to that beautiful enchantress who appeared at his castle seeking shelter from a bitter storm.
Well, look, in his defense, the beautiful enchantress was dressed like a peasant girl. And you know, they come from very different class backgrounds. Anyway, so if he only has moments left, who is he gonna try to convince to love him? It's not gonna be the voters of Kentucky. Like, they might, you know, support him. I don't think they're in love.
There's only one Koch brother left.
That
would explain in basically the parts of his body that are battered and bruised are the same ones that he uses to pleasure big money donors.
Oh, okay. Because
it's also his mouth and his hand. Nope, I'm just saying.
We're not.
Well, John, anyway, this hand is hurt. This one is bruised and battered. And then
his other hand is too.
You have that last photo, you can see his mouth.
Let's bring up the last photo.
It's his mouth.
He's got yellowing around his eyes.
That checks out.
Okay. Well, anyway, here is what I have to assume. Like, I would, you know, like, theories aside, he fell, I think.
Yeah.
And people are saying blood thinners and stuff, potentially, but he didn't bruise his face. Like, it could be some sort of blood thing. I think he just fell. And I guess maybe he doesn't want to seem frail or admit to weakness in the days before an election. That's just so stupid. Just admit that you fell. You're an older person. Older voters probably understand that. That's a threat that they have to deal with. Just be real. He can't be real about a simple thing like taking a tumble.
Yeah, which he obviously did. The other explanation is, I don't know if other people have watched Lovecraft Country, but there is a guy who, like, doesn't he have like grafted black man skin on his body so he doesn't die? That's what he's got. He's like taking, he's got a very like Jordan Peele allegory situation going on that's keeping him alive.
Exactly. Yeah, it's deep. It's a good metaphor for American race relations. But anyway, get better, buddy, and then retire. Get out of here because you're stopping much needed aid to the American people. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.